So I'm here to talk to you about lantana. It looks a very innocent kind of flower. Many of you must have seen it. But let me tell you that it's a big nuisance for our ecosystem dependent people. It is one of the most invasive plants in the world. It's one of those 10 most invasive plants in the world. And it covers more than 4% of our landmass, Indian landmass, and it is found across the length and breadth of India. And it creates immense pressure on our livestock owners. It creates immense pressure on our forest dwellers because it eats up those resources on which their livelihoods depend. We call this active management for lantana. So rural communities, they manage lantana on their common lands, forests which are adjacent to them, and some of the private lands which may have got infested by lantana in the years. It is largely about eradicating lantana once, but it requires a lot of aftercare. That is where community participation becomes very central to our effort. And communities provide that very important element of aftercare. They keep on removing small lantana seedlings, saplings from the site, which has been cleared of lantana. And also benefit from fast coming native species, which provide them fodder and important forest produce, which contributes to income. So 1 hectare of such land actually releases some 10,000 to 20,000 rupees for them every year. So far we have removed lantana from around 5,000 hectares of land in more than 500 sites around Kanha Tiger Reserve. The program actually is now in a stage, it is already 5-6 years old. So we would like to see that it gets now some kind of recognition beyond the landscape, and it travels to other places. To understand what active management is, let us take a look at this diagram. This is particularly showing up a typical forest interspersed with agriculture kind of landscape. You have a big forest patch in between, and it has a core and then a forest fringe area. Largely the forest fringe area is slightly more open, so there is more space for lantana to grow, and largely this is the area which is thickly infested with lantana. To share with you a few, there's one from Indravan. We eradicated this lantana from this site in 2014, and now you see by 2019 the land is already revegetating. People are taking fodder from that land. The other side, you can see it's a slopy site from Chichari village, which we eradicated only in 2017. And in just 2 years, the land is back to its natural state. So, and it is being accessed by people. People are using it, thereby reducing pressure on much deeper forests nearby. We would like to see that this experiment now, it is ready to scale. If it is given a shape of a program so that there is more use of such experience, and there is more community participation elicited for such activities, and it is taken to such landscapes where forest is interspersed with agriculture, and it is only possible when conservation and livelihood outcomes are seen together, and Forest Department, Department of Agriculture and Animal Husbandry should see some synergy, because the outcomes actually promise for all of them.